Paul is looking towards God. Lord, what do you want me to do? The Lord gives him a vision. If a bike we have the petrol to push that bike. We have the electricity to move on into light. The same way, God gives a vision, a word to Paul. You hold on, my son, to this. And in its right time, I will fulfill it. And definitely I will fulfill it. The vision God gives to us is very important. We need to move on in life. If you look down at what happens around us, we will be easily pushed off. Pushed away. Our mind is never stable. Whatever it sees, immediately it will fall for it. If somebody says anything, it will immediately react to it. This is human mind. It has to be rebuilt. It cannot be simply swayed away. Anybody says, and you become like that. No. The eternal principles, eternal word should build up a man's life. And that's what was given to Paul. My son, there are so many souls in the world and in this town itself. I have got thousands of people for me. And you remain. It is I who have chosen you. And I am with you. Now nobody can touch you. Now, this promise of God, this vision of God made Paul so powerful. He never got afraid of anybody. Because God has said, the God of heaven has told me that through my life, thousands of souls are going to be saved. He kept alive that vision and he moved on, powerfully preaching the word for 18 months, 1.5 years, and built up a beautiful community called the community in Corinth. And the people caught him. That's all they can do. People can try to do anything, but when the promise of God is given to you, nobody can stand against, because every ruler, everything is, everyone are controlled by the Lord. So they took him to the governor, and the governor did not even allow Paul to speak. As they were complaining to him, immediately he said, look, this is about your law, about your thing. Don't bring all these things to me, to the governor. Get out from here. Go. Paul was just pushed away. No court, nothing. When God pushes you, nobody can pull you down. When God moves with you, nobody can take you back. He is there, your God. Keep alive the love for winning souls for him. God has given you the salvation. And if you and I are born only to win our soul and die with that, it has no meaning. We have to win the souls of many. So many people are in need of God. God's love, God's forgiveness, God's mercy. First, we need to see our own family people are saved. If we get angry on our own people, if we start to blame our own people, we become cause for them not to have the salvation. We give them opportunity to struggle with the problems. No, we are not the source of problem. We are gifts. We are God's children. So let's celebrate the salvation God has given to us. Yes, that is our protection. Every day we need to celebrate this salvation. When you celebrate, even the evil force cannot come near you. That's what St. Paul will say in Ephesians 6:17. Have the helmet of salvation. Every day celebrate what the price Jesus has died of. He has paid for you. And he has brought salvation to me. And this salvation everybody should have. And I need to commit my life for a higher goal. And Paul did it. Many problems will come. Don't get upset because problems come. Because people are trying to trouble you. Don't worry. That comes on our way. They pulled him to the governor. But God, as he has spoken, as he gave the vision, he took care of Paul and brought salvation to the world. And he wants to do the same to you. In your life also, there will be many problems. Don't get upset. Don't get upset and react to the problem. Rather, you have to respond to God and bring God's vision and God's salvation to this world. Today, Jesus says the same. To work for God, to bring salvation, is not an easy thing. He compares it with a woman who is giving birth to a child. She has to go through a lot of struggle before giving birth to the child. But once the child is born, she is so happy. She forgets about all her pain. In the same way, when we move with the vision of God, we will bring forth many souls to the world. And bringing souls to the world is the greatest joy. God told Monica, you save the soul of your husband. You save the soul of your son. And she made her son a saint. Wherever God has placed us, learn to love people. Learn to forgive people. Learn to bring forth God's presence. Our life is only once on this earth. We brought nothing by proving myself great among others. What am I going to win? What am I going to achieve? Nothing. Let's become the two hands God has given in both the sides. It is to gather. It is to build up. It is to push up. Yes. Let's join with the vision of the Lord. Let's build up people. Let's show compassion to people. Let's show mercy to people. Even if you know your husband has done something wrong, your wife has done blunders, what is the use of telling that in front of your children? What are you going to gain? Prove yourself you are better than your wife or your husband. Is that going to bring salvation? No, there is the works of the evil forces. No, never do that. Build up, Lord. Move with the compassion of the Lord. Move with the word of the Lord. And win souls. First, you win your family to Jesus. Let your family be saved. And then, through you, save as many people as possible. When the Lord is coming, His second coming is very near. All that happens in the world is only telling us, not to frighten us, but draw close to God. Draw close to God. Purify your soul. Return to God. And any time God comes, you can be prepared. You can be joyful to go to Him. May God speak to us and lead us.